Kyle Montgomery, a.k.a. at 3x3 The Voice on Instagram, in your ear. Kenyon Berry. NBA legend and Hall of Famer Rick Barry's young one. Nash. Oh, pass is mishandled. Quick clear by Beijing. Kickball, fresh shot clock for Beijing to start with it. They got here via a wild card host spot, Beijing that is. Princeton qualified from finishing second at that Edmonton Challenger. They're gonna watch Pyongyang shoot one here. Payne pings it off the iron. Did not have the touch. Stay 0-0. Isaiah Wilkerson. So misfire, long rebound goes to Beijing. Whoa, on the go. Holla at you later. He'll get the scoring started for the Chinese. Chinese-Serbian mix as Marko Savic checks into the game. Seeing his first action on the Pro Tour in at least a couple of years. So Beijing happy to add the services of a Serbian legend and one of the most skillful players the game has seen. If 3x3 has a Mount Rushmore, Marko Savic's face is gonna be on there. You can believe that. Isaiah Wilkerson cares nothing about what's happened in the past. It's about the present. What have you done for me lately? Kenyon Berry gets the crib. Pyongyang. He'll misfire. Rebound, and that one is put up and in. So Yanbo Zhu. Berry, that's a rerun. Same episode on the baseline. He finishes with another reverse. Yang fading away, fouled. On the shot attempt, Berry will get a rest. He's holding his right ankle. So Pyongyang get a chance to shoot one. He's played in 7 World Tour games. 4-3 record. Has never medaled in a national team event. Expected to be tight early. Both of these teams considered. Well, Beijing certainly considered to be an underdog in this competition. Princeton certainly considered a contender. Princeton doing some creative and innovative things with their Dow project this year. Gives fans an opportunity to have ownership stake in the team. So they have turned fully professional. Then I'm back to run the show. You took my heart. See what happens when we have delays in the game like this, I start to sing. Return of the man. I love you. Okay, I'm gonna get in trouble. I need to stop. I will. Let's see what they're figuring out. But I was speaking of that, this the Dow project for Princeton, fully pro. We're seeing more and more teams that are using sponsorship like this. It's a new movement in sports altogether as they built the first fan-owned professional 3x3 franchise. So through either direct financial contribution or by completing a task for the team, you can earn ownership tokens. They are a decentralized, autonomous organization. That's what DAO stands for. Working with the Kraus House DAO, or Pioneers. Check out the Kraus House DAO. And Pioneers in sports ownership. So a cool thing the Prince is doing here in 2022. But they got to get some wins. 2-3. Beijing. The whip, but nobody was home. Nash couldn't track it down. Okay. 1 second. Guo letting it go. It's gone. You have to retrieve that from out of bounds. Minute and a half in. Game number 3 in the main draw. And they mismanaged that possession as well. So both teams got some things to clean up here. Just getting started. That Marco Savage, the surgeon, is back. I told you, he passes like the valedictorian does all the time with ease. Sets up the smash. Nash misses the freebie, or the layup. It's a clean look. Nice form, but not a nice result. That one goes off the rim. Savage looking to set the table. He sets the screen. Savage will get it back. The up fake. The surgeon drives, leaves it short. Maddox will keep it alive for Princeton as the madman clears it himself. Kareem to Canyon. Barry in the lane, missed it short. Savage now has it. He's assessing the defense. Oh, the surgeon tries to set up a teammate. Quick hands from Princeton to poke it away. Nash to the madman. Maddox trying to set up shop. Foul called on Beijing. Take another look at the setup from Savage, which leads to the Yammy. Yanbo Zhu. Wilkerson missed the shorty. Quick clear, trigger, pull. Touches nothing as Ping Yang couldn't get it to go. I think Ping Yang has even filled in for Lehman on the Pro Tour at times. Again, he's hoping that he's got a home, a regular home in Beijing. Meantime, Kareem hit that one from LA County, 4-4. No answer from Beijing. Just in front of the logo, the madman's got range to spare. Got a good service plan. As we're all even at 4-4. 3 minutes in to game number 3. Group C action. Sixth stop on the world tour this year. In case you haven't been keeping up, it has been an OOB takeover in 2022. They won our first 4 events. Antwerp finally stopped them in Debrecen. So in the 5 stops, 4 wins for OOB, 1 for Antwerp. Who's next? We're gonna find out as a Junkyard Dog. He marks his territory as he gets to the rim and lays it in. He's here to play. Zayday. Isaiah Wilkerson now in hot pursuit. Trailing Pinyang. Travel is called on the entry pass. Here's the madman. Kareem, Dime Time. I like your cut. Canyon Berry has it a 6-4 game. It'll stay that way thanks to some solid defense on the interior from Princeton. That'll leave 7 seconds left on the shot clock for Beijing to get to it. No need to rush. And get a good look right there. But it's a misfire. Whoa. He's stripped. What you got? 10 minutes print to 21. I doubt that either of these teams will get to 21, judging by the pace that this game has started with. 3.5 minutes in. And the buckets have been hard to come by. The surgeon misses it. Oh, look at Canyon Berry on the cut. Missed that one that time. But Beijing mishandled the possession. They'll turn it right back over to Princeton. Zayday gives it up. Kareem Mannox, he decides to let it fly. Flies right into Zay's hands. And Wilkerson called for the travel. He was hoping for a foul call. But you ain't gonna get away with that. Two-point game it stays. Savage in his return to the World Tour. Can he lead his Beijing team to victory? He's gonna get some help. He's also got some guns on the outside. Hanyu Guo. Two-piece, makes it 6-6. Here's Guo letting it go. Look at the wrist work from him. Berry. He's Berry fast. 7-6 from the G-Leaguer. Canyon Berry. Zay gets it down low to Nash. Before Nash can get a shot up, he's fouled. That is number 4 on Beijing. Another look at Berry. A blur on a drive. CB over to Kareem. Mannox down to the block. He's able to draw the foul. He gets a whistle. Shooting foul. Kareem, who helped lead Princeton to their first and only Masters title 3 years ago. It's been a 3-year drought, but they got it done in El Segundo. So this American powerhouse is looking to get back to those winning ways, and that will not help their cause at the line. Mannox missed it. Playing well this year, though, Mannox. More on that later, after he does something good. Savage recovers the ball. Tried to find a Zoo on the cut. I believe that went off Zoo's knee. It did. So Nash will give it up to the Junkyard Dog. And he dribbles it off his ankle bone. Out of bounds. Under 5 to play in a 1-point contest. Princeton. They got 3 runner-up finishes this year, Princeton that is, including the Utsunomiya opener. Can they take the next step? Wow, whoa, with the step back. He sticks with it, and persistence does not pay off this time as that's poked out of bounds. considered to be a shocker and their first bit of business. So they topped Jacque Gubale. Before that, it was a 21-15 win for Riga over Lublin Lato. That's how we've gotten to where we're at. Guo! Faster than Sonic. Mannox gives it up to Zayday. Double foul. .3 left on the shot clock. Six fouls on Beijing, none to give, and four on Princeton. Nash puts up the shot, but his J is laggy. And Wilkerson, lackadaisical in defending that too, and they're made to pay. Oh, gangster slap from Marco Savage. So we saw the two-piece from Jan Bosu and the defense from Savage. He's on Savage time. A Savage block, 12-8 Beijing. Guo hands it over to Marco. Here's the Serbian. Was not so precise on the layup attempt. Push on Black as Canyon Berry hits the deck. Berry has spent the last several seasons in the G League. We'll get our first look at him at the free throw line as he continues the tradition of two-handed free throws in his family. I jinxed him the last time I started talking about his percentage, but I'm not lying. He makes these at nearly a 90% clip. He's stunting like his daddy. Something like his daddy, who also shot his free throws at a nearly 90% clip. He goes 50%, splits a pair. I jinxed him again. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to speak the facts here. Meantime, he's letting his wrist talk. That's Guo. Put some English on that. 5-point game. Oh, Madman. Nice move, bought some extra levitation time. Floating like a butterfly, stinging like a bee. 14-10, whoa with the step back. Take another look at Maddox. He shot the ball up on his way down. He's averaged 6 points per game this year. He's been a bright spot, as usual, for Team Princeton. Meantime, they left Berry alone, but he has reservations for two now. 2-point game, Beijing still in front. That one out of bounds over to Green. Take another look at Berry. Wrist work, swish work. They go back to work, top of the key. Berry this time from the logo, it's a no-go. Rebound to Gray, Beijing now back with the Wilson in hand. Savage trying to set something up. Offensive foul call on Beijing. No free throws after an offensive foul. Somebody tell Canyon Berry. Only on defensive fouls, sir. You're gonna have to earn this one. They check it up. CB with the jab step. Shields the defender, textbook lay. Canyon Berry looks like a nice guy, but he's tough as nails. Don't get it twisted. Meantime, Guo getting faded. Step into the barber chair. It's 15-13. Berry to the crib again. Layup. 1-point contest. Savage setting the table. Down low, up and in. Jan Bosu, he's been getting to it. Nash will go up. He takes the feed. That's good eat. It's going back and forth like an Aaliyah track. In a 1-point contest. Beijing with 8 fouls, though. Princeton in a lot better shape defensively. Only 4 fouls for them. There's the setup from Berry to Nash. Teamwork making the dream work for Princeton. But they do trail it by 1 with 1:15 to play. They'll get a chance to get their win. They'll reassess the situation. Check out our social media account if you get a chance. When you get a chance, at FIBA3X3. We got the best captions in the game. We got the best media team in the game, led by none other than the great Julien Dubov, Above the Rim. Give him a follow, at Above the Rim. All right. We get back to the action. Savage has the pass broken up. He tries to lose Wilkerson, but Wilkerson sticking with him like gum on a shoe. Savage is arguing with an official, and he's going to get hit with a technical. They've heard enough of it. Happy to have him back, but we don't want to hear you. We just want to see you. So Canyon Berry will try to even this thing up at the free throw line with his first attempt. Don't you dare call it a granny shot. He makes it. Two hands for safety. 16-16. Every time he shoots the free throw, though, I have to resist the urge to say, "Wee!" I don't know why. Barry, how do you put that together? Something's got to be called here. That is a travel. I knew it was something. And now Barry's arguing, so he's going to get hit with a technical. No talking back. So each team assessed the technical for yapping with the officials. And neither one of them play that. Debating is not going to get you very far. He makes good on the technical free throw. Beijing leading 17-16. Guo will kick it out. Good look. Su could not knock it down. Wilkerson will track it down. Wilkerson with a strong drive and a soft scoop. Two is released. Misfire. Zayday trying to set something up with Nash. Nash ran into trouble. That loose ball ends up in Beijing's hands. Payne will kick it out to Guo. Guo lets it go. It's a no. We're down to 20 seconds in this game. 17 all. Isaiah Wilkerson. Zeke shoots and misses. 9 seconds to play. Guo will get it down low. A potential game-winning shot, but he got his pepper picked by Zayday. Zay puts it up, no. We're going to overtime. Overtime. 17-17. If my memory serves me correctly, Princeton started with the possession in regulation. So if my memory is not failing me, then Beijing will get the possession in overtime. Take a look at that last sequence, last couple of sequences. As Nash was defended well, Guo with the kick out. Both teams stepping up defensively. Wilkerson will get in for the score that tied things up at 17 apiece. And that's exactly how we will go to overtime. First team to score two in OT wins. Keep up with the action again at FIBA3X3. Use the hashtag 3X3WT. Make sure you tag Maurice Lacroix, because we're going to get a Maurice Lacroix buzzer beater one way or the other. Savage, precise on the pass as he sets up the alley-oop finish for Zoo. Barry gives him one right back. Next bucket scores 18 apiece. Marco Savage setting the table, and this meal is finished. Your Maurice Lacroix buzzer beater finished with a shorty. Yanbo Zoo. The dude was everywhere in this game. The veteran Savage gets him the win in overtime as Beijing shocked Princeton. Here is your Maurice Lacroix buzzer beater, set up by the Serbian surgeon himself, and finished off by Jan.